One thing you want to know with brows is to follow the golden ratio. Everybody has a different face, everybody has different bones. You can't like have the same eyebrows as like Kim Kardashian if you're not. And that's okay. Like you should have the brows that are for your face. And in order to do that and nail it every time, you follow the golden ratio, which is following the inside of the nose up. That's where the brow should start. Arch should go from this angle from the inside of the nose. And then the tail should end right here. So as long as you take a brush or a stick or a toothpick, whatever you want, and just measure those three spots, you're gonna have brows that frame your face beautifully, and it's gonna be a great setup for the rest of your face for makeup. That's why I always start with brows. First, I'm cleaning up the brow. Cleaning up that line right there, so it's super precise. And then I'm just applying concealer all over the lid. The base for all the eyeshadow. Make sure it's really blended out so we don't have any creases. You can take a little bit to the top as well just to clean up that edge and make it really nice and neat. Then I'm going to take my beauty blender. This is already damp, and I'm just going to blend out any edges so there's no weirdness or creasing or extracurricular activities coming out the side of the eyes that we don't want. So after that, I'm just going to take Laura Mercier Translucent Powder. This is a really light powder, so it's great for like in-between steps because it's not going to get cakey or weird. And just literally take a little bit, dust it off, and set the eye. Again, this is just putting a really nice base for all the eyeshadow we're about to put on so that when we blend it, it looks super flawless. First thing I'm going to do is highlight the brow bone. So I'm just taking a highlighter. This is called Fuego by Debbie and Katie by Joseph Colors. And another thing is, like, I'm going to name some of the products I use, but by no means, like, do you need to do these things with these products. Really just pay attention to the steps because you can kind of do anything, like, with anything as long as you know how to use it. I'm just highlighting up here right on her brow bone. face to be snatched, okay? So like, you don't want, like, you don't want it to come out and then go up, right? You want everything to just kind of look like it's seamlessly. Like, you want to think of like parallel lines, like everything going in the same direction. So in order to do that, you kind of follow the shape of the eye to up into the temples. And I like to do what's called cheating the eye. So rather than coming directly out the corner, I go a little bit in, like a centimeter, so that it makes the eye look a little bit more lifted. So go ahead and open your eyes, but kind of look like that. So you just draw that line up, and then you go about like a little bit down, and try to draw it just straight in right here, as opposed to curved. Make sure you're not just matching it directly to the face. You want to match it more to the skin, so that you don't have a white face and then like tan shoulders.
So when you do this, you don't look like you.
So I like to use a brush. When I'm doing liquid foundation, I use a brush with synthetic hairs just to kind of sipple it onto the face. And then I go in with my beauty blender. I like to make sure I put some product on the beauty blender before I put it on the face and then warm it up. I just find this helps it blend better and really press it into the skin. So this is what's gonna make your makeup last a long time, is that it's really pressed in and it's becoming one with your skin. And I think this is where the term beating the face comes into play, because you're literally getting beat, you know, by this beauty blender. I'm sorry. So with foundation, you don't want to do like a super thick layer all over. You just want to apply more like in any areas that you're trying to cover up. You don't have to do, if you feel like you're having like a bad skin day, you don't have to apply a ton of makeup all over your face. Just give a little bit more love to those spots that you feel need it. Now I'm going to go in with some cream contour. I like to use the Fenty matchsticks. I'm going to be using the shade Suede. It's just a cream contour stick, and you want to take it on your hand first to kind of warm up the product so it's nice and blendable. And then again, take a synthetic brush, because we're using a liquid formula, warm it up, and just kind of go in the hollows of the cheek. You don't want to take it too low, because again, we want everything to be lifted up. So I want to lift up her cheekbones. I don't want them to be drooping down. It's going to do the opposite of what you want. And contour is one of those things that's very personal. Like, everybody has a should have a different like contour places where you're putting it. All contour is doing, you're putting darkness in the areas you want to make smaller, and putting lighter product in the areas you want to highlight and look bigger. So that's going to be different for everybody, depending on the shape of your face and your bone structure. A little bit of contour down here so that her neck is super snatched. And I'm doing her cheekbones. I'm doing a little bit on her forehead. Like, don't do things just because they're steps. Do them because they make sense for your face and your bone structure. I'm going to take a little bit on the nose. And then I'm kind of continuing this brow bone effect that we have from the eyeshadow and blending it down the nose as well. Okay.
That that was all the suede color?
Yeah. So when you do anything on the nose, make sure you do a super light amount, okay? So just a tiny bit of product on that brush, because you don't want it to look too crazy. I'm just doing some additional blending with the foundation brush. And now I'm gonna go back in with my concealer. Conceal under the eyes. I try not to take my concealer all the way to the lower lash line, because we're gonna put some eyeshadow there anyways. And just don't need to have concealer all the way up there. And you can also use this to kind of help guide that eyeshadow. So I take a little bit on the nose. Again, this is just help shaping the face. The more, when you take concealer on the nose a little bit, it just makes the nose look even more snatched. Take a little bit down the center. So we're just highlighting the high points of her face. And we're gonna go ahead and press it into the skin with our beauty blender. Always kind of warm it up a little bit. Going back in with my Laura Mercier translucent powder, taking a little bit, and I'm just gonna put it on like one of these little puffer pads, kind of dust it off on my skin, and just press it into the skin. Again, we really wanna make sure everything's pressed in. This is what's gonna make it last longer and look like skin, as opposed to just makeup sitting on top of your face. Okay, now to highlight a little bit more, I'm gonna go in with my beauty blender. Make sure it's damp. Take a little bit on the pointed edge and go ahead and smile. So I'm going kind of from like the top of the ears to the corner of the mouth. And this is just gonna help sculpt out. You could smile like a little bit less. Yeah. Just kind of so I always do this like awkward smile when I do makeup, because it's like you wanna have the cheekbones poke out so you can see what you're doing, but you don't wanna smile too much where you have lines, because you don't want any makeup to fall in the crevice. Sorry, I should have told you that.
It's okay.
And then I'm just going and baking in all the areas that I highlighted. So go ahead and look up. And now when we go to work on our lower lash line, we're gonna have a little bit of help right here. If there's any fallout, we can just dust it off.
What's that powder again?
It's Laura Mercier Translucent Powder. Okay, so now I'm gonna go into the lower lash line. I'm just taking the colors we put in the crease, these browns. Look up. I'm going right here on that lower lash line. Depending on the shape of your eye, you can take this all the way in, or you could just kind of focus it on the outer corner. But don't be scared of this step. I feel like I used to be scared of like looking like too like, yeah. But it actually just like completes the look and makes the eyes look better, and it helps complement all the makeup you just put on the top part of your eyes.
What color did you use?
I used these two colors, this light brown and like warm brown. And then you could just go in with your fluffier brush and just really blend out that line. Okay, now we're gonna go in with our contour, powder contour. So I'm taking the Anastasia Beverly Hills contour palette, and I'm just taking a little bit of the lightest shades, dusting it off, and using circular motions to apply it to the cheeks. Make sure you don't use the brush like this, because we don't want to have any harsh lines. Just circle, circle, circle. You can take a little bit of the lightest shade, dust it off, and do the nose if you're into that sort of thing. Okay. And then we can go ahead and dust off all this excess powder. Today, which I feel looks best in photos. I'm taking the shade Sugar Pie by Morphe. I'm gonna overdraw her lips a little bit in the center, just so it kind of has that pout right here. A little bit on top, and then follow her natural shape down to the corners. You can put a little bit more on the corner. Kind of just leaving the center of the lip a veil. What color is that? This is Sugar Pie by Morphe. Okay, go ahead and like pop your lips together. And then I'm gonna take this nude shade, I believe it's called Trimpton by MAC. But you can use any type of nude shade. It's like a light pinky color. And this is the kind of thing that you sort of play with and find what works like best with your skin tone and your face. But basically, as long as you're following the guidelines of like a darker color on the outside and a lighter color right here in the center, you're in good shape. And then I'm gonna top it off with some gloss. This is Dose of Colors the Most. And apply it mainly on the center. And go ahead and pop your lips together. And close your eyes. So I'm spraying the skin with some rose water. This helps melt the product into the skin. And I do this before I do mascara. Since it is a water, I don't want the wetness to make the mascara and the lashes look crazy. So while we have the skin a little bit damp, I'm just gonna quickly do some blush. Blush is the first thing to fade away, so if you like a rosy cheek, go ahead and like get in there. This is NARS Orgasm Blush, which is like an OG classic. Mm-hmm. Looks good on everyone. And just apply it to the apples of the cheeks. You can kind of do like a light smile to really make them pop and blend that into your contour. And then I just take a little bit everywhere just so everything's kind of seamless. What color was it? Orgasm by NARS. And then I'm taking a little bit of highlight on the high points of the cheek, the nose, the lip, right here, and the inner corner of the eye. You want to apply a little bit of mascara to the lashes. This is just going to prep them for the falsies that we're going to stick on. Go ahead and just look straight ahead. Make sure you get it at the root of the lash. And look up. Don't forget the bottom lashes. Okay. Fake eyelashes. You want to take your lash and usually it's good to trim a little bit from the outer corner in, just to make sure it fits your eye. If the lash fits your eye as is, totally great. If not, take a little bit and trim it off at the outside. Lashes already come tapered and you don't really want to mess with that, so it's best to trim from the outside instead of the inside. Then you're going to take a little bit of glue. Apply it to the lash, just right there on the strip, and let it sit for a moment so it can become tacky. If you apply it right away, you're gonna be in trouble because it's just not gonna stick yet. It's still like very like slippery and it's just not sticky yet. And then you're just gonna be stressed, and then you're gonna get glue on your lid, and you're gonna be like wanting to cry. Now that the first one's kind of dry, I'm gonna have her look down, but don't close, okay? And I'm putting this right in the lash line as close to the base of the lashes as I possibly can. When you close your eye, you run the risk of having some of the glue stick to your lower lashes, which is also gonna be a stressful moment for you. So I like to position it from the center and then kind of adjust the corners after to really stick them into place. It's better to have the lashes on your lashes as opposed to like on your lid. But the main thing is you don't wanna have any space between the strip and your eyes. And make sure they're dry. So I'm kind of pushing the strip like under that little piece of skin right there and letting it fold on top so it just looks really like it came out of the room.
Do you start from the in to the out?
I start from the center and then I kind of just position the edges at the edge. Dry. They're still kind of drying a little bit. I'm just cleaning up this piece of glue that I got right here. So you could just kind of pinch them together to your real lash. You could do this with tweezers or your fingers. Take a little bit of mascara. And then just from the base of those lashes, kind of blend it. Mascara on the face, just wait for it to dry and you can flick it off with a Q-tip. Okay, so that's pretty much the final look.
Like, comment, subscribe.
Yes. Be my bear. Hey.